All right, we'll move on to Sierra Leone, where a Chinese mine worker at the Dakolili, Dakolili mines has attracted wild condemnation after a video showed him attacking a Sierra Leonean safety officer on site. Now, according to the report, the miner who works with Kingho Mining Company was not pleased with the safety officer, and an argument ensued between them, which prompted the officer to react. Let's take a look at the video.
Leave him, he's on record. Hey. He's on record, leave him.
Oh my gosh, quite distressing scenes there between the miners, employee and employer. This is really, really serious one. But we are now joining us is Abdul Malik Bangura. He is the public relations and media officer at Kingho Mining Company. Abdul Malik, good morning to you. Welcome to Breakfast Central.
Good morning, my brother. Good morning, my sister.
Looking at the video that we've seen, can you tell us exactly what transpired in the video we just watched?
Actually, the Tonkoli iron ore mines is the largest iron ore deposit in Sierra Leone. What happened is that previously, before now, we had several issues with regards to safety, environment, and community. So as a result, what we did was to get a routine safety meetings in almost all the departments in the mining site. That particular department happens to be the mining department, which is operated by the CRSG, which is Chinese Railway 7th Group. In our particular company, Kingho, we have several subcontractors working there. This particular Chinese officer is not an employee of Kingho Mining. He is a subcontractor staff working for CRSG. While the safety officer, whom you see in that video, happens to be a Sierra Leonean worker, and he is the safety supervisor for Kingho Mining. So he was actually trying to sensitize some of the local staff on site about some of the safety measures that has to be taken in place whenever you are on site. Then the Chinese came and said, no, the guy must stop with the sensitization process. And immediately, all the people that were on the orientation exercise should return to their various duty posts. So as a result, the Sierra Leonean refused. That was when you saw the Chinese guy came and then had to push the Sierra Leonean and then the files and all the papers which had the safety instructions fell on the floor. So that's what caused the confrontation. But in reality, our company, Kingho Mining Company, vehemently and unreservedly condemned every act of violence on site. We actually did not support the Chinese, even though our company is a Chinese company. The CRSG, The CRSG, they are subcontractors only for the mines, to mine. We also have other subcontractors there. We have the Wanshi Mining. They are the ones operating the processing plant, and then the TLO. We have Protect, responsible for security. We have several subcontractors working under us. So that particular police worker is a subcontractor. But just yesterday night, let me just confirm this to you.
Okay.
The CRSG issued a press release that they have already dismissed that Chinese officer, while the Sierra Leonean is currently in the hospital.
Wow, Abdulmalik. So he landed in hospital, which means he received serious injuries, perhaps from the weapon or whatever it was that the Chinese staff used in attacking him. But what has been the reaction so far of Sierra Leoneans? And we know that Kigo has come out with strong statements, and you just told us that the Chinese staff has been, dismissed, reprimanded, and the other staff of Sierra Leone has been in hospital. But what are people talking about? What are people saying about this case? And it's in terms of employee, employer, boss relationship, proceedings in Sierra Leone?
Well, basically, honestly, my brother, a lot of Sierra Leoneans condemned the act of the Chinese worker. And I think that was what changed the decision of CRSG. Initially, CRSG was the first company which issued a press release in the morning hours. CRSG issued a press release in the morning hours. In fact, they blamed the Sierra Leonean for all what happened. That was why in our press release in the afternoon, we said we condemn the statement of CRSG because it prejudiced the investigation process. They went on and said that it was the Sierra Leonean who first attacked the Chinese. We condemned the CRSG statement. That was why CRSG came again with another statement in the evening hours now, which I will share with you later, and then saying that they are going to release the Chinese. In fact, we are the one, because we have the concessional area, we have the license to operate. We told them that this particular guy is not going to be in our site again. So
Abdulmalik, I mean, with what we're seeing and what has happened, I mean, a lot of people are asking, and looking at the effrontery with which the Chinese staff was able to come out and take on such action, is this the first time such an incident is happening in King Oil Mining Company, be it with the contract staff or even with the full staff of the company? Is this the first time such an incident is happening?
This is the very first, and it's a very, very isolated incident. It has never happened, because the unique thing about our mining company is that King O, most of the top officials are Sierra Leoneans. Most of the top officials, the management, most of the main management staff are Sierra Leonean. So over 90% of the workers in the mining site are Sierra Leoneans. So it is very hard for you to have a Chinese dominant to the extent that a Chinese will come and then hit a Sierra Leonean. It has never happened. Okay. In our side, it has never happened. We believe in tolerance. We ensure that we comply with the various local statutes, including the local content policy and all the labor laws of Sierra Leone. There has never been a case where a Chinese officer or a Chinese personnel hit a local staff. It has never happened in the operational areas of King O. This is a very isolated incident, and this has been the very first. And that is why we have taken a very, very robust action to ensure that this precedent does not continue. Because if it does, it will be a very bad egg going forward for the operations of the company's project.
All right, so some strong statements now released by your company, Kigo Mining. Are we saying that, in the future, especially for not just for Kigo Mining, but other, multinational companies where you then have foreign staff in Sierra Leone attacking, local staff, going to the extent of using weapons to attack? Are we saying this can really nip this in the bud, if ever it can even happen again in Sierra Leone, or in terms of employee and foreign employer and local employee relationships?
Well, I don't want to be pessimistic, but if we are to be optimistic, we believe that this particular action by King Ho to unreservedly condemn the action of a fellow Chinese officer, it must be symbolic to show that we must not condone any act of violence, either perpetrated by any other person. We must all come out as a nation or as a people to condemn any form of violence. It could be me, it could be you, or it could be any other person going forward. But we must all condemn any act of violence. We believe that this action by King O management is a very good precedent to show that other multilateral companies coming into Sierra Leone must create the enabling environment for their locals not to be maltreated. Because even in our constitution, there is always a constitutional provision which frowns against inhuman treatment.
Okay. All right.
Anyone for inhuman treatment. You must ensure that you protect and uphold the fundamental rights of everyone, be it a Sierra Leonean or a Chinese, in as much as we are trying to create the enabling environment for investors to come into the country.
Thank you so much.
That's not used as a conduit pipe.
All right. Abdulmalik Bangura, thank you so much, public relations and media officer for Kigo Mining Company in Sierra Leone, for coming up and really clearing the situation with the issue with the Chinese staff and the local there. Quite a terrible incident, but thank you very much for coming on Breakfast Central.
Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my sister.